Okay, guys, God bless you guys. Here we go. Get ready. Buckle up, folks. This is off the charts. This is just not even on the charts. It's going to blow your minds. It blew my mind beyond my ability to almost deal with it. So just buckle up and get ready. It's mind-boggling. Okay, the other day, on my birthday, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten, his only born son, monogene, means the one and only, the only one of its kind ever. Monogene. He gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. So I have a little church building outside that I built where two containers were previously. One was built and remodeled, sent to Grand Junction to the corner of Rainbow and Casimir. It represented the Bride of Christ. Another container was put in a place. The Lord told me to convert it and send it to the same place. I sent it to the same place. Even after a big struggle with the city of Grand Junction and getting through people that tried to stop it, they tried to put a stop to it. And then the Lord had made sure they both got put side by side, one representing the Bride of Christ, one representing the judgment seat of Christ. And all the artwork that was in each container bared witness to what was going to happen and the meaning of the two that came together. I'm not going to go over it all. If you haven't seen it, I'm really sorry you missed it. Especially now. Because now there's a little building out there that's in the place where those two were converted and shipped off to the corner of Rainbow and Covenant of Peace, which is Isaiah 54. So as is with you, as it was with my servant Noah, I made a covenant. As I made a covenant with my servant Noah, which was the rainbow, so shall I make a covenant of everlasting peace with you. Rainbow, Casimir. That's where the two containers ended up. Okay, that's one in a trillion. But here we go. You ready? You ready to blow that off the charts, out of the water? Which is impossible. But we're going to do it right now. I guarantee it. This is like a biblical book. This is like the miracles of the Bible just exploding in real time. Corey and Kat, praise God. I was so glad they were here to be witnesses. So, what did I do the other day? I rang the bell. The Lord told me to wear all red. I'm just going to be honest with you guys. I find that kind of, why do you want me to wear all red? But I remember when he told me to wear all black and start driving to New York. And what happened? I ended up at This is it. The only two white people wearing all black. And we walked in the door. Some guy was going, praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And Lou had a nervous breakdown, basically, because she couldn't figure out how in the hell did Jonathan know to wear all black. We ended up at a restaurant where the only white people in the whole restaurant. There is a packed restaurant. Everybody was black, but we're wearing black from head to toe. And Jonathan said, we're all black. The Lord saying, we have to wear all black. And we ended up at This Is It in Houston, soul food. Okay, via trip to jail and all this other weird stuff. So, when the Lord told me to wear all red the other day, yeah, I was like, this ought to be good. I was just like, you don't know what's going to happen, right? And I even told you, is anything going to happen? I don't know. But I know what he told me to do, and I know he's got a reason for it. Y'all want to see the reason for it? Y'all want to be encouraged? You don't want to freak out? Okay. So I was kind of wondering, I was like, hey, when I put on all black, I ended up at a place called This Is It, This Is It. Back then he was getting me ready for what's going to happen real soon. So This Is It. What does that mean? This is what? This is the end of the world. He was letting me know way back then, this is it. And I've called you, Jonathan, as one of my witnesses, and you will be a harbinger for the Lord God. That's it. And he was right. So I put on all red the other day and I rang the bell on my birthday. Don't believe me. There I am. I don't wear red, by the way. Red is not a color. I don't buy red clothes. I don't have red clothes. I bought a red shirt because the Lord told me to. Someone actually sent me a red shirt that said 100% no lying on it. And somebody, I think, wanted it, and I let them have it. So
the little church building, there's the crown. Right.
So there I am with putting the crown. I had put the crown on the little church building, which is a representation of the church. What's the church? Upon this rock, Matthew 16, upon this rock I will build my church. What rock? And to you, Peter, I will give the keys to the kingdom of heaven. Put a key in, and the door opens. You turn it upside down, and the door opens. It retracts the bolt. That's how you retract the bolt. That's how you unlock it. So Jesus told Peter, I'll give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven. And Peter was crucified upside down. Jesus was crucified right side up as a representation of the system that's going on with inside every host body, an angel and a demon. That's why Jesus said to Peter, right after he said, hey, I'm going to call you Petros, which means little rock. And upon this Petra, massive rock, foundation, which is Christ, I'm going to build my church. And everyone that gets converted becomes a little rock that goes on the new church building. And the one on the bottom, which is Christ, serves everything above it. So one gets converted, put it here. One gets converted, put it here. And just picture a pyramid that's upside down. An upside down pyramid just getting built. Because the capstone, the one on the bottom, serves everything above it. Satan's kingdom is the opposite. Everything below serves the one on top, the all-seeing eye. Jesus' kingdom is the opposite. The greatest of all is the servant of all. So the one on the bottom, like picture an upside down pyramid, that block on the bottom, and then everyone that gets converted goes on top, makes a pyramid upside down. Jesus is the greatest of all because he's the servant of all because he died for all. Now watch this. Y'all want to freak out? Y'all want to totally freak out? Take your finger. Take this finger. When you get tired of using this finger, take this finger. Give it a rest. Get this finger. Because this is mind-boggling. I'm just trying to have fun because this is what I mean. This is just, this is the Lord, man. This is orchestrated by the king. Watch this. Ready? Here we go. Okay, so
me.
Let's see. Let's start it from
here. And with the little church building, there's the
so there's the crown on the church
right above me.
Okay, so well, I'm just proving that this is what I did. This is what the Lord told me to do. And then I walked over there and he told me to ring the bell. And so we're doing little 1 minute segments, right? So let's just get
today
to it.
3:16. Today's my birthday. Happy birthday! John, 3:16 is the date. March 16th. So I'm gonna ring this thing.
Okay, now watch.
What he said. So here we go. You ready?
Yeah.
Let's pause it and start with.
So I told Corey right there. Now check it out. Let me ask you this question. Just let me ask you a question. Do you think the Lord God's in control of? Was he in control of the very moment Jesus died? It's a yes or no answer. Was he in control of the very hour that Jesus died from 6 to 9. Remember, there was darkness over all the land from 6 until 9. And then Jesus cried out in a loud voice, Ali, Ali, lama sabachthani. So the Lord God was in control of exactly the hours when there was darkness over the whole land from 6. 6 represents the flesh. 6 represents the flesh. And then till 9, judgment. When you turn a 6 upside down, it becomes a 9. Just like Jesus on the cross and Peter on the cross. One right side up, one upside down. This is what I've been telling you since the night I got saved. You ready? Y'all want to freak out? Watch this. So I tell Corey, I'm like, okay, I wanted to make sure he paused the video for a sec because I wanted to be able to ring the bell and not run out of, because we could only do like 1 minute little bursts because my computers won't download. That's all the Lord too. Watch this. Watch.
And I'm going to do what he said. So here we go. You ready? Let's pause it and start with the rings. Okay, so here we go. Birthday ring, John 3:16 ring.
Okay, so there it is. I begin the bell ringing. So the bell ringing begins. Okay, so I'm sitting there just ringing the bell, and here we go. Watch this. You ready for the testimony? Let me get my cell phone. I have a couple of testimonies and revelations for this video that y'all are just going to be like, and I want to just go nice and smooth. I don't want to get in a rush. I don't want to forget anything. Okay, so let me show you my cell phone. I'm going to open up my pictures. And on my pictures, here is, I'm going to queue up the video where, okay, so here we go. I'm going to show this to you on my cell phone. So you can see these are all the little video segments. Like, see, there's all the little video segments that we had to shoot. And then I had to send them to Dave to stitch together because my computers won't download my phone. It's the weirdest thing in the world. I mean, how many times have I downloaded my phone? It's crazy. I'm like, what is going on? Can't figure it out. Watch this. Okay, so let me show you this. So there's the little video segment right there. That begins that video segment. Look right there. What does it say? 2:26 p.m. Right. That's when that video was made. Right now it's 12:28 a.m. and it's 2:26 p.m. on Monday when I rang that bell. So what? I'll tell you so what. So what happened the night I got saved? The Lord told me, hey, if you want to see the truth, you know, he said, read the tags in your shirt, Jonathan, read the tags in the clothes you're carrying. I read the first thing. It said 100% nylon. That doesn't make any sense. He said, turn it upside down. 100%. He said, turn it upside down. It was nylon turned to no lion. 100% no lion. And I heard the Lord say, you may not lie 1%. You must speak total truth. Because he was about to pour into me himself. He is the truth. So I was like, oh, 100% nylon. That doesn't make any sense. He said, turn it upside down. 100% no line. And then I said it out loud towards the ceiling. That's, I told you, my whole body lit up just buzzing. Since that night, all I've been doing is putting out the truth that the Lord God shows me. I've never seen anybody else on YouTube ever put out this information. Never. Nobody. I've seen people try and take my stuff and regurgitate it and do a terrible job doing it, but no one's done this. I want to give all glory right now to the Lord God. It's not me, it's him. He's just using me. Now watch. So he told me, look up 2:26, because that's when the part that was the ringing began. Let me just prove that to you one more time. You can look at it yourself. Let's see. Let me enlarge this. You can look at it yourself. There's a timestamp, Monday, 2:26 p.m. Right now it's 12:30 a.m. and I'm doing this video for you guys. Okay. So since the night I got saved, it's been 100% no line since 2002. I've gone through all this data, all this processing, all this information. The Vatican's a big snake wearing a crown. You know, the altars, all the clothing lines, all the stuff he's let me show you guys. I've just been putting out the truth that the Lord gives me. And I know the end of the world is here. Watch this. The Lord told me, look up. 2:26 in the Bible. And I looked it up and it said, the word is a sign, and there shall be a sign given unto thee. And I was like, wow, a sign. Well, that word sign is in many places through Exodus. And the Lord told me, look here in Exodus, there shall be a sign for you on the houses, and the blood shall be a token upon the houses. So let me just show you that real quick. So Exodus 12:13, and the blood will be a sign for you on the houses where you are. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you. No destructive plague will touch you when I strike Egypt. There will be a sign on the houses. Now, I don't know if how many of y'all actually know this, but I'm going to show this to you. The house that I live in, when I got it, had three head symbols on it, which is the same as the sign which was over the doors. There was blood down the doorpost and there was blood over the top. That's called a head symbol. And the house that I'm living in, it has three head symbols on it. And when I got the house, I actually contemplated sitting in the driveway, how am I going to get rid of those three red bricks that are just out of place? And I heard the Lord say, no, leave them. It represents the mercy seat. I was sitting in my truck. I'm like, what? I had so much work. I was like, what am I going to do with those red bricks? I thought they were out of place. And I heard the Lord say, leave them. Represents the mercy seat. And I checked with a friend. I said, what do you make of this? He said, it's the het symbol in Hebrew. And then I looked it up. It's the number 8. Het is the number 8 in Hebrew. And there it is. And there's 1, 2, 3. Het is the 8th letter of the alphabet. And 888 is Jesus, the salvation of God. So on the house that I had to remodel and literally gut and redo, was written in Hebrew, Jesus, the salvation of God. Well, I'll tell you what. That was mind-boggling back then. But now, just wait. I was like, that's crazy. So the Lord said, look up the time you rang the bell, Jonathan, which was at 2:26. And there shall be the blood shall be a sign unto you. Well, let me ask you this. What color did the Lord tell me to wear? Oh, he told me to wear all red, which I thought was weird. But the building, remember, is 76 inches wide, which the number 76 in the Bible is 1 Corinthians 15:45. You know what? Let me just show it to you. Okay, and it says, so we're talking about what's about to happen to all of us. And look here. It's talking about, here we go. And also the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption. It is raised in incorruption. It is sown in the natural body. It is sown in the natural body. Look what it says. Body slave. It is sown in the natural body. It is raised in a spiritual body. There is a natural body and there is a spiritual body. And so it is written, the first man, Adam, was made a living soul. Right here. See the first man, Adam? That's from Genesis 2, where the Lord God breathed into Adam the breath of life, and man became a living soul. And it says, the first man, Adam, watch. Adam, from Hebrew word 121, Adam, the first man of Jesus. Man is his representative. So then when you look up when you walk back to the very root of what it means, Adam, and you go back to 119, look what it means. It means to show blood. And it means red. I'm going to highlight that, kind of a reddish color. To show blood, red. Ready. That's what the root of the word Adam, as the first man, as the representative of Christ. Now, watch this. So, there shall be a sign unto you. The blood shall be a sign unto you. So, at the time that I rang this bell, 2:26... the word in the Bible is a sign. It's from Exodus. And in Exodus, it tells you, there shall be a sign unto you. And that's the blood that's on the doorpost. Now watch this. Then the word sign also means to speak the truth. See 2:26 again? Aletheo. It means I say and speak truth. Do truth, maintain the truth. Aletheo, literally truthing, speaking reality, truth into a person's life, making a record of what God deems is the truth, reality and fact. Now, I'm just going to be blunt. Let me tell you something. From the night I got saved, that's all it's been. It's been me speaking truth into the world. The Vatican's a snake. The Virgin, when you turn it upside down, is a dead sheep. The mouth of the snake that's the Vatican is a dead sheep. It's a vagina. It's the male reproductive system. It's male and female reproductive system. It's angels melting into semen. Just speaking the truth. Just telling you the truth. It's all I've been doing. Barack Hussein Obama, so Barca on his passport renewal from his mom. Hakrab Eos, scorpion goddess of the dawn. All I've been doing is speaking truth into this world and being attacked violently for doing it. Yeah. Ready? So 226 means to making a record of what God deems is truth, reality, and fact. It literally means to truth includes spirit-led confrontation where it is vital to tell the truth so others can live in God's reality rather than personal illusion. That's what 226 means. The moment I rang the bell, it means a sign. The blood shall be a sign unto you. I was wearing all red, and it means to speak the truth. What was I telling you? I'm ringing the bell because the end is coming, and I'm fulfilling my destiny as a bell ringer for the Lord God that I was called to solve the riddle of ages. All I've done is speak truth into this world since I got saved. Y'all want to see mind-blowing now? If that's not mind-blowing. Oh, there's more. There's a lot more. So, when I rang the bell, I was wearing red. Adam, 76. The building, 76 inches wide. Adam as Christ's representative. Red. Wow. 200, the length of the building, locust. Don't forget that, because that's going to be very important in just a little while. You're all going to be like, ah! This is so crazy. Watch. Okay. So now we got, let's say the words in their languages. I like knowing they're off. 226 is off, and it means a sign. The blood shall be a sign. And then 226 is also aletheo. It means literally truthing. To truth includes spirit-led confrontation where it is vital to tell the truth so others can live in God's reality rather than personal illusion. And that's what I'm trying to help everyone do. Now, here is a number, 140 from the Bible. Adonai Kom. See, like Adonai, calm. Adonai, calm. My Lord has arisen. So that's what the number 140 means. You may ask me, well, where does that come from? Well, I'm getting ready to show you. So let's go through a couple pictures and then I'll show you where 140 comes from. But I just want to do a little reminder of some stuff. Okay. Y'all remember the whole system's upside down, right? And they turn the mail upside down. Look what they have here. This is a skateboard picture. It says 888. And they have a guy inverted. Here's the Bloomberg guy that was running for president. Bloomberg 2020. Look, it goes up and it goes down. And the two O's, the reason they're doing that is because they want no more sheep, a null set, 00. No more. And that's the cryptic meaning of his thing in the presidential campaign. Bloomberg 2020. Right side up, upside down, 00, none left. Here's a little nifty cover for a DVD. It just came across my thing. I thought I'd show you because it matches everything. Dos Equis beer, the most interesting man in the world. He's always got two girls, two X. It matches Madonna coming up from the pit. But it's really fascinating because it's so telling. It says, from Magnolia Pictures, Four Deadly Tales by Four Deadly Women. What is it? It's a kiss. You know, like Jesus told Barabbas, you betray the Son of Man with a kiss? Because where do you think this whole thing got started? You think they just went straight to it, and when the serpent Lucifer inside the host body system went for Eve, or do you think there's a kiss? What do you think? See the kiss? See the two X's? Four deadly women, deadly tales by four killer women. That's kind of interesting. It's 2X. It's the same as Madonna. I'm just refreshing your memory on this stuff, but we're getting right back to the testimony. Here's some stuff from this stuff. Here's some images from the same thing. Look, it says one way, and look what's coming out the door. That's a female, and she's a killer. But look at the number 44. Four deadly tales by four killer women. A fish hook, the number 44. You know, remember YG? Hunted for dinner? What's the name of the shoes? Bait. What did I tell you the female host body was? For God's angels. Bait. Fish hook. Oh, four deadly tales by four deadly women. XX. 4-4. Bait. Fish hook. I'm sorry. Fish hook. There you go. Told you. So see, I can read their language. They have a language. It's a very, very concise, very, that they've really got what they do down. So now let's go back to the whole ringing the bell. Ringing the bell was at 2:26. There it is. There's the timestamp, 2:26. And it's 2:26, a sign. The blood will be a sign. Well, I'm dressed in all red, and the width of the building is Adam. Adam is Christ's representative, will be blood, is blood. Well, we know that the life is in the blood, and we also know that we're covered by the blood, which makes us exempt from judgment. That's really important right now, because you know what's coming? Judgment. And you know what I think's going to happen? I'm going to throw it out there, and I'm just going to show you what happens supernaturally. This is more of that testimony. I've been, y'all aren't going to believe the way this unfolds. I was like, well, what was the purpose of the all red, Lord? And immediately he told me, look up the exact moment you rang the bell. I was like, really? To truth and a sign. Well, just wait till you see this. Watch. Okay. So, there shall be a sign unto thee, and to speak truth. Well, y'all know that the V for Vengeance logo that was on the parachute I jumped in Grand Junction, it makes an X. Let's just take a look at it. We'll take a look at it. We'll enlarge it, and then I'll just make sure this one's ready to go. Just down here. Okay, just sit tight. And I'm sorry, it won't just tab to the bottom, but I'll scroll this one down and I'll get the other one ready. Here we go. There we go. Okay, so there you go. So that's what the Lord God himself told me to put on my parachute in Grand Junction. V for Vengeance. And it's right side up V and an upside down V. Hey, let me ask you, do y'all know what the new Wuhan handshake is? Y'all know what it is? Anyone know? Y'all know what the Wuhan handshake is now? Wuhan 400. Remember, what's 400? Hunted for dinner, right? 400 means prey. Food. V for Vengeance. Well, that makes an X, but it's a right side up and upside down V touching each other, right? Okay, well, let me show you the new Wuhan handshake. It's right here in the, y'all want to take a look in the photo album and see all this stuff. It's really cool. Let me show you the Wuhan handshake, the coronavirus handshake. Here you go. Here's what you do. You walk up and you touch your elbow to someone else's elbow, making a right side up and upside down V. Wow, that's weird. Or you walk up and you touch feet, making a V. Here they are touching elbows, the Wuhan shake, or the elbow bump, the new coronavirus greeting, where you walk up and you point your elbow right at somebody, and then they touch it with their elbow. What are you really making? You're making an X. Hey, what's up? Because that's the new race. Do you get it? So they're all walking, hey, what's up? They're touching, because has anybody thought about, how come there's no pushback about shutting everything down around the whole world? Who's making the phone call telling everybody, well, you got to shut down everything? It's like, what? It's like, whatever, man. More people died of the H1N1, 40,000 people, and they weren't making any big deal of it at all. You get a couple, you know, well, I think there was 19 people, which means slaughter, last I saw, that died in the U.S. 19 means slaughter. They said 19 people have died in the U.S. 19 means slaughter in the Bible. When Barack Obama was president, they were like, well, 10,000 people have died, but Barack's doing a great job. It's like, how are they getting everybody shut down all of Las Vegas? How are you shutting down every gym, every theater, all of Las Vegas? Everybody stay home. This is it, guys. This is where, yeah, your worst enemies will be members of your own household. Remember, I have warned you. Children will turn their parents in, and they'll be delivered up to be killed. So look at the Wuhan handshake. Does it remind you of a parachute of a guy named Jonathan that you know? Oh, is that like the V for Vengeance thing on his parachute? Gee, it sure looks like it. I mean, what's the difference? You know what? It's the same as all this stuff you see, like these games. Patima inverted. Look at that. Is that a girl and a guy right side up and upside down? Let's see. Let's take the Johnny logo and just put it right there. Oh, wow. It's the same thing, isn't it? It sure is. Because God's going to take vengeance on the system. Is it any different than no lion in nylon? No, not really. Because one's a lie and one's the truth. Is it any different than Jesus and Matthew 27:45 from the sixth hour to the ninth hour? See, the six is black and there was darkness until the ninth hour when he died. And that's when the light was available because he went back, ascended to the Father. And then he sends the Holy Spirit to live in us. And the Holy Spirit converts us from angel demon just to the Holy Spirit, all angel. And we're converted back to God. System makes perfect sense now, doesn't it? Watch. Oh, it gets better. It gets better. So anyway, so now we know, there's no doubt about it, that the king is coming. And let me show you another really interesting thing that I got before I share with you that other number where it said, our Lord has arisen. I looked at my new Creator Studio thing the other day and I popped it up and this proves it. And it says, so I'm looking at my stuff, and it says, your new creator roundup is here. I'm like, oh, wow. Well, that's no different than a 6 and a 9, right side up, upside down. Look, there's a bell ringing. And look what's coming out of the envelope. Bugs. Oh, that's weird. And did you know that YouTube is saying, hey, we're real sorry. We're not going to be able to do like manual checkouts of videos, so there's going to be a lot of videos that get deleted that aren't violating our community guidelines, meaning we can delete anything they want, even if it's not in violation because of the coronavirus, because there's no one to manually inspect your videos. That's a good cover story. Nice. So check it out. Let's zero in on that roundup, because they're going to round up the sheep, guys. Now look at this. What's pulling the letter out of the envelope? And what's on the letter? An X. Oh, weird. And look at the bell. The bell's ringing. And what's coming out? Bugs. You mean like locusts? Yeah. And they're just doing it right in front of your face. Roundup. See the right side up, upside down, and the fish hook, and what's coming out? The X, like the female chromosome, and the bugs are coming. And your new creator, because the world has a new creator, and he's the one that gets to run the show. It's his world now. Satan. Satan's ruling earth. Told you. And they're right in front of your face. And here we go. Now let's, I'm going to show you the house one more time, because now I'm going to drop this mega bomb on you. This is going to blow your mind. There you go. Hang on one sec. Okay, let's look at a picture of Johnny's house and the fact that... Where'd it go? Okay. There it is, right there. Okay, so I'll just kind of stretch these two out. So there's the house. There's Het, Het, Het. And then 888, see 888, and I'm just going to prove it to you that literally on the house I live in, here's what 888 means. The scripture teaches that the name of Jesus is the only name under heaven whereby men might be saved. We have the identity Jesus equals 888. This number integrates with all ideas of the number 8, such as octave, new beginning, and entrance into God's covenant. Perhaps the most amazing occurrence of this number is found in the divine prologue, Jesus and Yahweh. So there it is. 888, there is the walls of my house. There's an 8, there's an 8, there's an 8 in Hebrew. Jesus, the salvation of our God. Now, watch this. Now, imagine you're me, and you just got through ringing a bell wearing all red. You're like, what was that all about? You know, because I was like, okay, I rang the bell, and I know there's a reason for it. And the Lord says, look up the exact minute you rang the bell. I'm like, really? So I look it up. I call Corey, and Corey's like, did you read the other definition? I'm like, 100% nylon, 100% no lion, aletheia, speaking the truth into this world reality. Because everyone's living this crazy ass illusion. This whole place is a freaking farm. It's a farm where a bunch of God's angels got trapped in host bodies. And they're being self-cannibalized by a demon that's attached to a locust in a pit that's eating them from the inside out. Just like I showed you at the Medici church and mansion that the Medici family owned, where Michelangelo was carving shells of people's bodies with worms in them, like a caterpillar. Oh, just like it says in the Bible, I'll restore to you the years the cankerworm has eaten. That's why people in the Senate are coming up with bill numbers to save the cankerworm, but pierce the number they used for the bill number for the abortion was, when a baby comes out, you could pierce it with a bicycle spoke, a syringe, or, let's see, bicycle spoke or syringe or knitting needle. And the bill number meant to pierce. Give me a break. They're freaking monsters in human skin. They're scorpions. Thou dost dwell among scorpions. They're scorpions from the pit, walking around in their little hose bodies, and they see the ones that are this, and they're trying to get you into all kinds of sin, then you die like this, and your soul goes to the pit. Unless you get converted, and your eyes become single, you don't go to heaven. Told you. Been telling you. Now watch. So, I'm going, so, the whole red thing, Lord, I mean, I felt your presence big time when I was pulling down the bell. And I know that the building represents from Adam to locust. Let me ask you this question. What happened back in the days when they had to leave Egypt, right? Remember the night I got saved? First thing I had to do was read that first tag, 100% nylon. Made no sense. 100% no line. Turn it upside down. Oh, wow. What was the second thing he told me? The pyramid's your enemy. There was a triangle with an X through it. And I heard the Lord say, the pyramid is your enemy. And I was like, what does that mean? The pyramid's my enemy. It's a race of means. The pyramid, the ones that were ruling over the Israelites. It was a manifestation of the gods of Egypt that had enslaved God's children, the children of Israel. Israel, he will rule as El. Okay, so what did they do back then to make sure they didn't get by the angel of death? They had to have the blood over the doorpost, right? There had to be blood on your doorpost and over the lintel. It had to make a head symbol in the lamb's blood, in unspotted lamb, which was a foreshadowing of Christ coming. So way back in Exodus, the Lord God knew that Jesus was coming because he is Jesus. He was going to come in the flesh as the Son of God. So they put blood on the doorpost, blood on the lintel, making a hat symbol. You ready? So after I asked the Lord, so what was the ringing the bell all about? He said, look up the very moment you rang the bell, 2:26, to speak truth into the world. And there shall be a sign given unto thee, the blood shall be a sign unto you that you're covered from the angel of death. Well, let me ask you this. What are we expecting, or especially what am I expecting that might happen? Because I have artwork in there that I did before I got saved that shows Adam in the Garden of Eden having sex, has angels coming down from heaven, having sex with human women, and coming out of the wall from behind all these naked women, or all these locusts, kind of like the women were bait, and the locusts, oh, so somehow I carved exactly what I'm revealing right now. That's weird. What's really weird is there's a building out there that's exactly 76 inches, Adam as Christ's representative, same as my artwork, and 200 on the building, which is locusts, same as my artwork from before I got saved. That's so weird. That's impossible. Yeah, it's pretty impossible. You want to hear really impossible? Well, the Lord told me, I want you to paint a red on the doorposts and over the lintel of the little church building after he showed me 2:26. And I was like, okay. And so I said, Lord, would you please just pick out the paint color? Will you just walk me straight to the paint color? And let me just pick out whatever color you want. Well, you want to hear something really interesting? The other day when Corey and Kat were in town, we're going to go have our last meal out. And we're going to go to this place called Max and Louie's New York Diner. And we were talking about how we laugh a lot because we have Christ in us. So we're always full of joy. We're always laughing, having fun. Like, dude, can you believe that? Oh, my God. And we're like, isn't it weird how they like to mock us? And they have, I've seen these guys with tattoos and shirts. It says, laugh now, cry later. And I'll have tragedy and comedy. You know, the face smiling and the face, you know, the face making a frowny face. Well, I said that to Kat and Corey. I was like, isn't that weird that they laugh at us? And it says, laugh now, cry later. Because they know that when it's over, they get your soul. I said, isn't that just disgusting? Well, we go to Max and Louie's and the place is desolate. This place is usually just packed. And we go over there. There's only a few tables in there because everyone's scared of the coronavirus. And we're sitting there and we're like, wow, there's hardly anyone here at all. And some guy walks right up to our table and he's got on tragedy and comedy. And it literally says, laugh now and cry later. Okay, so when the Lord told me to paint the head symbol over there, I said, you know what? Just pick the color out for me. Let me show you the color. So I went to Home Depot and I walked straight over to the paint and the Lord picked out this color right here. That's me at Home Depot. I took my picture. I was like, okay. I'm like, just pick out which one. I think it was this one. This one looks the most like blood. So I just reached over and I pulled it out, and let me show you what that is. There we go. Let's give this a sec. Just bear with me for a minute on the buffering. Otherwise, I gotta pause the whole program and then restart. There we go. Okay, so here it is. It says no more drama. Well, that sounds great to me. No more drama. What a weird name for paint. That is really bizarre. So I decided just to go online and like, is there another meaning for drama? I just thought, let me check this out real quick. So I typed drama into Google and look, so I type in drama just to make sure that it's not something else, but no, it means and an emotional or unexpected series of events or circumstances. And sure enough, look what's sitting right there. Tragedy and comedy. And I thought, how weird is that? I just mentioned that with Corey and Kat. And then walked into a restaurant that was desolate. And one of the only people in the restaurant that came in to sit down literally walks right to our table, right in front of it, and had it says, laugh now and cry later. And now I'm picking out a paint that says, no more drama. Well, that's weird. It gets better. I hear the Lord tell me, look up the number on the paint. At this point, I'm like going, okay, that's a little far out there, the number of the paint. But I've seen this before, and I'm like, as impossible as it is it possible that the paint number could be pertinent to a head symbol over the doorway of a little church building here in my house? Is it even possible? Hell no, it's not possible. But all things are possible with God. Oh, I remember, I already showed you the meaning, didn't I? I showed you the meaning of 140. What's the paint number? 140, right? My Lord has arisen. Take this finger and go like this, turn sideways and go. Are you kidding me? My Lord has arisen. Now, ready? I'm sitting there just postulating, going, what in the hell? The paint means my Lord has risen? And there's no, and the building inside has the risen Christ flying away in a bunch of doves? Are you joking? Are you kidding me? That the number of the paint equals the risen Christ, and I'm doing red head symbol in a number that means the risen Christ. It's like, what? That's impossible. While I'm freaking out, going, what in the world? I'm on the phone with Corey. I'm like, Corey, check this out. And I'm talking to Corey about the possibility of, like, I'm talking to Corey about the head symbol being over the door that where the angel of the Lord couldn't come and kill the children of Israel if the paint was on, if the blood was on the door. And I was talking about that, and I'm sitting here at this computer, and I open up my email, and this friend of mine, Trey, had sent me an email, and I looked down at the email, and I went, what? Check it out, watch. Here's the email. I saved it. So let me make sure you understand. The blood on the doorpost is Passover. So when you have blood on your doorpost, that was called the Passover. And the angel of death passed over everyone that had the blood on their doorpost. Well, this is the New Testament, and Jesus Christ is the sign that we have the blood. We're covered by the blood, so we're covered from judgment. But have you ever thought, have you ever read Revelation 9, where it says, and the locusts had tails like unto scorpions, and it was commanded that they not hurt the grass or any green thing, only those men that have not the seal, you know, kind of like the doorpost thing back then, the seal of God in their foreheads. Huh. Well, you know that building is 76 red, Adam is Christ's representative, to locusts, right? 200 locusts. The length is 200, which is locusts. God is perfection. You're seeing perfection right now. Now, ready? Huh. So back then in Egypt, if you were covered by the blood, you had the blood on your doorpost and stuff, you wouldn't get killed by the angel of death when it came. I wonder at the end of the world, when the locusts come out of the pit. Well, if you have the seal of God, they got to leave you alone, don't they? They can't sting you. Well, what's the seal of God? Well, you're covered by the blood. Do you find it weird that the Lord just had me go paint red on that little church building on the doorpost and over the lintel, making a red head symbol out of a paint color that says no more drama, which is all this damn world is, total drama, and that the number 140 means my Lord has arisen, and it's on a building that shows the Lord rising. Do you find that a little bit weird? Do you find that a little bit strange? You know what? At the very moment I was talking to Corey about this, I was like, dude, this is insane. It's almost like we're going to be passed over because I'm putting red on there like the blood. So like we're going to be passed over. And then I looked down at my emails and I just about needed a Depend diaper. Locust swarm on Passover. I was like, what? Locust swarm in Israel on Passover. What? You think maybe the Lord might be trying to give you a sign? I don't know. I'm just like rolling with this. I just do what he tells me. There shall be a sign given unto you. 2:26, you know, the very moment I rang their bell, there will be a sign given to them. Ding, 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 I'm ringing a bell, there's a sign. Huh. To speak the truth, the sign is the blood over the doorpost. This house has three head symbols, like three doorposts, 888, Jesus, on the front of the house. The back of the house has a head symbol that's red on a little church building that has the risen Christ, the Holy Spirit, taking off like a bunch of doves. And the paint color means my Lord has arisen? And there's going to be a bunch of locusts descending on Israel on Passover? What? What? No one could even think this up. Let me prove it. Say, look, locust swarm on Passover. Let's go back to here. Okay. My Lord has arisen. Wow. The paint color number is literally my Lord has arisen. It's probably just a coincidence. Nothing to see here. Let's see. Let's get that one going. Let's get this one going. Let's see if it'll... here we go. Let's see. You ready? Let's just take a little look at a few things. I'll just stretch them. So here's the crown I put on the other day. We have a thing called the coronavirus that comes from serpents. The Vatican is a big serpent wearing a crown. You know that, right? Yeah. And here's a little church building. Put this little building next to the Vatican. That would be comparable to the truth. So there's the red that I painted right over it. And there's the color red. The color red means he has arisen. No more drama. Wow. The inside of that building has an image of Christ rising as a bunch of doves flying away, a silhouette turning into a bunch of doves. There is a supernatural testimony about this Royal Enfield and a supernatural testimony about these guys crossing the finish line, 206. From the one end of heaven to the uttermost part, he will gather his elect. 230, assured. And 277, immovable on the rock. 536, the first fruits of the sacrifice. Did you know that the first part of the Passover is the first fruits? Yeah. So, I wonder why he had me ring that bell wearing all red at exactly 2:26. What do you think? Do you think any of this is possible? If you do, you're a lunatic. None of what I've shown you is actually possible. None of it. But all things are possible with God. Because he's the Lord God. He's the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. He runs the whole show. See, Satan thinks he's running the whole deal. This is where everything gets flipped. Watch this. Let's go back down. Let me show you something. You see what you're looking at? What does that look like to you? You see this? That's a pretty darn big $100 bill, right? It's pretty big, right? What am I doing with this thing? Well, let me see if I can find my little thing for my testimony here. It's here somewhere. Just get, there we go. Let me show you something I made. You see this? It's a necklace. This is to help people that may be left behind that might need to know some knowledge. There's a Twin Tower bombing. On the back of it is the Pentagon. There's the Twin Towers falling in its own footprint on the old tin. There's the federal building bombing in Oklahoma City. There's the tidal wave coming over a $10 bill. Coming over a set on the $10 bill. A tidal wave coming over a 7-story building. And here's New York, the $100 bill. Shows New York being devastated by nukes and water. What's really interesting is I've done most of these bills, but then one day I said, you know what? I'm just going to pull the trigger and I'm going to put a $10 bill and a $100 bill in plastic for people. It's worth it just to memorialize the facts. So I went over to Kinko's FedEx to do this, to make this so it would be proof that there was a prophet among them. And when I went to do that, I came back and all of a sudden I had some crazy craving for chicken livers. Everybody's like, what? Yeah, out of nowhere, I'm like, I've got to have chicken livers. I've got to have them now. And I told Kat and Corey, I'm like, guys, would y'all go with me? I'm freaking out. I got to have chicken livers. I just got to have them. That's kind of weird, right? Really weird. So they were like, cool, so whatever. I said, you guys can get whatever you want. Bush's Chicken is great. So we drive her to Bush's Chicken. And when you go there, you pull up and there's three cars. Like, they have three lanes. And people come out and take your order. And then they go back in with your order. So it's kind of weird. You have three different lanes. And it's kind of just awkward. So anyway, we pull up and this guy comes out. And I'm like, hey, man, yeah, I want an 8-piece chicken liver. And, Corey and Kat order, and because they make them fresh, he's like, hey, can you pull up a little bit? So I pull up a little bit. And then don't forget, this is right after I had the $100 bill encased in plastic. That was kind of a big move. It's like, that's $100 that's not ever going to get spent. It's just going to sit in a little plastic sleeve. So I was like, I got to do it. So I went and did it. And then we go get chicken livers. And then, we pull up, and then while we're waiting for our chicken livers, we've decided we're probably going to just pull over and have a little tailgate party in the parking lot. But I decide to get out, go in. I got to run to the restroom real quick and wash my hands. And I run in, and when I go to the bathroom and I go to the little place to pull your paper towel down, there's a giant freaking $100 bill. Look at this thing. It's like it's sitting up there where you right on top of the paper towel dispenser. I'm like, what the heck? I'm like, that is so weird. I just had a $100 bill encased in plastic. And I thought, well, you know what? It'd be really cool if it had the picture on the back, but it didn't. And you know what this $100 bill has on the back? It's telling you that you're a sinner. And if you don't repent, that you're going to go to hell and that the time is here. I was just like, it's like, you know that your day, it could be in today. Your death could be today. You could die this very day. In this whole thing, I mean, I could read the whole thing, but to find this and to find the message on the back. You know what? I'll hold it right there and you can pause it and you can read the whole thing yourself. It's just unbelievable. I was like, you can't even think this up, that this would be waiting in a bathroom. So that means I had to be the first guy there to get a paper towel because somebody else would have grabbed this thing. This is, I mean, pretty unique thing. You know, somebody look at them and go, oh, wow, that's pretty. I picked it up. I'm like, oh, yeah, it was left there. And then when I turned it over and I saw it was a message to try and get you to believe, be a believer in God, I was like, well, obviously the Lord sent me over for chicken livers because he had a bigger purpose. Well, what's significant about the $100 bill? Well, let me show you a video.
This is going to be New York City, and you're going to see the water.
Where? Hang on one sec.
Coming through now after this.
Very strange.
Where are the buildings?
Okay, hang on. Here we go.
New York City. And you're going to see the water coming through now after this. Here are the buildings. Here are the buildings right here. See the buildings right here? Okay, you see all this ink right here that makes the unidirectional lines? There's darker ink in certain spots. You'll see it. Okay, these unidirectional lines is movement towards the subject, which is us. As I change the magnification, you're going to see all of this. All of this is going to turn to waves coming in from those nukes that went down, and they're going to be destroying the city. Watch. Here it goes. There it is. See it? See how it changed? See how it gets all fluffy? Boom. There it is. Buildings being wiped out. There it is. See the water? That's water. I'm going to go back. Look. There it is. Now picture the water coming at you. Boom. Boom. Now picture the water coming at you. Boom, 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 boom. Devastation. Let me show you what's going to precipitate that.
Okay, so now I want you to think if you were me and you were the guy that the Lord God had called and he had shown you what was hidden on all the U.S. currency. I'm the guy. I'm the guy that the Lord revealed this to. And you walk into a place in a fried chicken bathroom and there's a $100 bill and you've already been here doing this whole bell thing. Do you know what's on the $100 bill? Do you know what's in the inkwell? Did you know there's a bell? Did you know there's a holographic strip with bells on it? Oh, that's weird. And I had just rung the bell. Yeah. So, do you think?
Which is on the new $100 bill? It's coming.
Now, let me show you something that happened in 2008 before Obama became president. Let me give you a prophetic utterance the Lord gave me. Okay, I just want to give you guys just look at this. Just look at what you're going to see. This is from an older video. I've known for a long time what was coming. It's here now. There's no doubt it's here. Have you ever seen the whole world locked down before? Who do you think's making the phone calls to get everybody to lock up every casino? How come there's no pushback? How come there's people not saying, hell no, I'm not going to do that. I've got to run a business, man. There's more people that died of H1N1. You know, there's 10,000 people. There's only 19 people in the U.S. And you're telling me we got to lock down everything? Why? I'll tell you why. It's a spirit that's doing it. Because that spirit is taking over. It's going to take over the entire human race. And if you don't go along with it, then you get killed. But there's also the church that's going to leave, the bride of Christ. If you're ready, if you made yourself ready and you knew Jesus was coming and you just kept believing and kept saying, I know he's coming. How could you not know he's coming? I'm serious. If you're a true believer, how could you not know he's coming? I was like, really? Have you looked around? I'm going to show you some videos here at the end of this. I'm going to give you guys a video link. Go watch this video link. It's real good. But I'm going to show you a trailer and a couple other things. How could you not know he's coming? Everything's been revealed. Now watch this. Just watch of the intensity of all this. This is the back of the $100 bill. That's a missile going into the water, and that's on the backside. Look at the different layers of ink. Watch. That's what's coming. Now all you have to do is go watch the DVD we did, Destruction of America or Crowning the Tyrant, and you'll see other images on the US currency that have all been hidden right in front of your face. But if you look, there it all is. See the different layers of ink? Watch what there's the missile hitting. There it is going in. There's the water coming up and the nuke beginning. There it is. All right, also on this bill, there's this blue stripe. It's a hologram. What it is, it's, if I move it around, it's the Liberty Bell and it's ringing. If you move a hologram, the hologram moves. So if there was a clanger in there and it's going like this, what would it be doing? It would be going ding, 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 ding. They are sounding their alarm. This bill is a vehicle to distribute their plans. That's what they're doing. These are their plans to nuke the United States. It's Satan's plan, by the way, Satan and the fallen angels, but we have members of our government who have been taken over by demonic spirits, and they're part of this. There it is, this blue line. It also represents a water event, and it's the bell ringing. They're ringing the bell, and I'm ringing the bell. So
okay, I want to just jump in again. Just think about that. There's a bell. There's a bell on the $100 bill. There's a holographic bell. And then the prophetic utterance the Lord gave me in 2008 before Barack Obama became president. It's all happening right before our faces. And the sea shall turn terrible before your very eyes. And the terrible one shall be elevated within the sea. Sea of humanity, the terrible one, the evil one. He's taken over the sea of humanity. It's happening right now. You can watch it happening. The sea shall turn terrible before your very eyes. And the terrible one shall be elevated in the sea. Behold, the man of sin, Barack Hussein Obama, shall come forth from the sea, and with words of peace, he'll bring chaos and destruction. Who started all the crap in our government? The Obama administration. It's where it all got going. That's what's all panning out right now. It's so crazy. Okay, let's keep watching.
My name means Yahweh's given a bell ringer. So I'm sounding the alarm. Prepare yourselves. I don't know the hour, the day, the month, or the year, but I'm telling you it's coming no matter what. In the story, folks, get ready. Jesus is coming. So is the end. World War III is upon us. It's the Liberty Bell, and it's ringing.
So, do you find it odd that there's a bell on the $100 bill that shows New York being nuked? Do you find it odd that I'm ringing a bell on a building? It's got 17 on the bell. 17, that which is inherently good. 76, Adam as Christ's representative. Right out of the Bible. Do you find it weird that every number associated with what I'm doing is a perfect representation of what I'm doing? I mean, how does that happen? How's that possible? How's three guys running on a track with numbers on them add up to a key of a motorcycle, 1901, to stretch forth to the finish line? And everything just adds up to perfection. I mean, it's pretty insane, isn't it? It's like, you couldn't even think it up. You couldn't even imagine it. But yet, we're looking right at it. Told you. So, now let me show you something else. The plague of locusts is to descend upon the Middle East in time for Passover. What? Yep, right here. Plague of locusts are going to descend on the Middle East, descend on Israel in time for Passover. Literally, it says for Israel. Plague of locusts set to descend upon Middle East in time for extremely alarming desert locust swarms forming in Horn of Africa, but will skip Holy Land. So the swarms of locusts that are going to be heading towards, and it says, here you go, desert locust, whatever that is, Schistocerca gregaria is the most destructive migratory pest in the world, according to the Locust Watch website, as depicted in the book of Exodus. When highly mobile swarms of desert locusts form, they are ravenous eaters who consume their own weight per day, targeting food crops and shortage food crops and forage. So, with the capacity to consume the same food in one day as 35,000 people. Well, it's heading towards the Middle East and the Holy Land. They're saying somehow it's going to skip the Holy Land. That'd be kind of cool, wouldn't it? Wonder what the odds are that it's descending on the Middle East during Passover into Egypt. Isn't that where it happened back in the days of Moses? Yeah, that's pretty close. I think that's pretty fascinating that locusts are going to be hitting Egypt and the Middle East. I believe that. And I'll double check, but I'd say, I believe it said moving into Egypt and the Middle East during Passover. Do y'all know the story of Gideon? Y'all know how the whole story of Gideon, how he, you know, he had to go up against the Midianites and I think the Amalekites, right? And I believe the number was like 180,000 guys. Then he had like 3,000, and the Lord whittled him down to 300 guys. Now, let me ask you a question. How in the world are you going to go fight? The way the Bible describes, I think it was 180,000, but I think the way the Bible described the number of Midianites and Amalekites was they were as numerous as locusts. Grasshoppers, watch. Let's go to Esword. So here we go. And the Midianites and the Amalekites and all the children of the East, like the Middle East, just lay along the valley like grasshoppers. Look, a locust from its rapid increase, because this whole breeding thing that we're caught in is metaphorically, it's a metaphor. The host body system is used to breed locusts from the pit. So these stories in the Bible, when it's comparing them to them, is because it is them, because they use the host body system. The host body system is what? An illusion, a phantom image a vain show. Remember Genesis 1? Now it all makes sense. That's why they created the host body system, was bait for God's angels. Victory. Now it all makes sense. The whole Bible makes total sense now. So, we have a locust swarm descending on the Middle East. It says it'll, they say it's going to skip the Holy Land, going into Egypt during Passover. I wonder if Passover might be a time that we might be seeing locusts from the pit. I wonder if we might be seeing them tomorrow or the next day. All I can tell you is this. Everything the Lord's told me to do, everything, has proven to be supernatural. All of it. All of it. Lay hands on the plumber, Juan. He's blind in one eye. 15 minutes later, he can see. He's got an image. He had a tattoo of the Virgin on his left arm. It's so crazy. You know, all these crazy things that have happened. All this revelation of data, all this information. Look what the last 48 hours have been. There's red paint on a church building that means no, the little swath says no more drama, tragedy and comedy. And the number that was, my Lord has risen, on a building where it has the risen Christ. Just think about that. A color. A paint. Painted over the door, the lintel and the doorpost, like Passover. It's like, so, you know, I don't know what to say, except this is so beyond my pay grade. It's like, I'm just going to go with it. So, yeah, it's just, it's unbelievable. I almost don't know what to say, except it's all true. Aletheia, to speak truth. It's pretty cool, right? Pretty unbelievable. It's here. So, let me ask you this. Do you find it odd that I've had a truck since July of 2019 that has a right side up red V representing Christ and the good, and an upside down with fangs representing that which is vampiric? And that happens to be the new handshake. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. V touching V. Is it weird that my parachute and the symbol V for vengeance happens to be identical to the new coronavirus handshake? Is it weird that I looked at an email while I'm talking about the Passover and I'm talking about the Lord having me put red paint on a building that represents the church? You know, the church, which is the, you know what the word church means? Those that are called out. Don't believe me? Anyone not believe me? I'd love to show it to you. I love using the Bible to show people the truth. The Bible is the truth. The Bible is the Word of God, is Jesus. Jesus is the Word of God. So when Jesus says, I'm going to call you Peter, which means little rock, and upon this Petra, massive rock, Jesus is he's the foundation, and then Peter is the first building stone, the little rock. That's why they did their first lockdown in New Rochelle, new little rocks, fully contained the new little rocks, like Peter, because we're like Peter, we're little rocks. We've been turned the opposite direction. We know the truth. So, upon this rock I will build, look, my church. There it is. Read it for yourself. A calling out. It means a calling out. A calling out. Do you understand? We're called out of the world. We're in the world, but we're not of the world. We've been called out of the world. It's so profound. The Bible is so profound. It's so many layers of just mind-boggling perfection. And now he's letting me get to see his perfection in a little building that I was obedient to do. The end is coming. The bell's been rung. I hope you're ready. I hope you've made your peace with God. If you haven't, I think for you, those of y'all that saw the testimony with Brandon and Brandon's dad, when the Lord told me to go lay hands on a guy that was basically in a coma, ready to die, and the Lord told me to go lay hands on him, that I would know he heard me. He told me what to say. He told me to touch him and whisper into his ear. And he told me what to whisper into his ear. And I told Brandon, and the Lord told me I would know. And he was unresponsive for 2 days. And when I prayed and laid hands on him, he opened his eyes. And then after he opened his eyes, we were like, oh my gosh, he opened his eyes. We're all like, wow, what? And we're all just buzzing. And then I started praying again, and he opened his eyes again twice. And then the Lord confirmed it after that. And here's the reason I'm telling you that there's still hope as long as there's a breath. As long as there is a breath in your body, you can still make your confession. Just admit it. You're guilty. 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 As charged, I admitted it. I was like, man, I've done so much shit in my life. I've done so much stuff. I deserve to go to hell. That's what I said. I was just disgusted with myself. I'd made the $1 million. Girls, 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 party, drugs, whatever, everything, whatever people want. I had it. Everyone used to tell me, man, dude, I want your life, Johnny. You got the coolest life. And I was thinking, yeah, you know, it's fun, but it's really kind of vacuous. Unfulfilling. I cried out. I said, this sucks. And the reason I cried out is I was put in a position where I saw little children, because this girl I was dating got pregnant on purpose, and now little kids were involved. I'm like, oh shit. Well, I can't just, I'm sorry if that bothers you, me saying, you know, oh shite, but that's what I felt like. That's what I said. I was like, oh my God. Now there's these little kids. Who would do that? Who would bring little kids into the world and make them part of a bad relationship on knowing that it was bad? That's so messed up. Oh, it was a trap. Yeah, she set a trap. What did she use as bait? Her vagina. Yeah. I'm just being straightforward. She was really attractive. And I was like, you know what? Hey, if you want to just have sex and have fun, that's cool. I'm going to California to train for the X Games sky surfing. And she was like, oh yeah, okay. Just wait till I get you where I want you. It's like, how'd she do that? Bait. And then there was the little kids involved. And I took a stand where the little ones were more important than my own life. And God gave me the courage to do it. Stand up. Say, you know what? And that's when I quit being self-centric and I became other-centric, and God had mercy on me. And then he let me be a harbinger. Woohoo! Yeah, and then I've got my ass whipped for 17, 18 years. It's been a long whipping. Yeah. So anyway, 2002, August of 2002. Wow. All right, well anyway, so I'm just saying, doorpost, red on the lintel. Let's take a look at those pictures real quick one more time, huh? And let's just kind of scan through those real quick. Nice big $100 bill. Message there. Locust swarm in Israel on Passover. That's pretty wild. Let's see. I don't know if, you know what I told you I'd do? We got to look through this. We got to watch this. Oh, my gosh. We got two more things to do, guys. See this right here? Motherland, Fort Salem, hated and feared, fear, and then the Avengers. Watch this. I'm going to pull this up. Okay. Now, Watch what's going on in the Avengers.
Begin. Number 1. Tony Stark figures out his time-traveling model after he draws mild inspiration from a photo of him and Peter in which they're holding an inverted diploma.
They're holding an inverted diploma. Well, what are they both doing? They're both making the V above each other's head. And then what's really fascinating about this whole thing is Tony's going to try and figure out time travel. And this thing that he's doing it on, it makes an X right here. And what's in the middle is a Mobius strip.
It's Friday to try a model of a time machine using the shape of a Mobius strip.
Time in the shape of a Mobius strip inverted, please.
Processing.
A Mobius strip.
If you're like me, you just...
A Mobius strip inverted. Do y'all know what a Mobius strip is? Do y'all have any idea? Well, if you look up Ouroboros and Mobius strip, I think your jaw is going to come off your face. You're going to be like, that's
impossible. Term as some science jargon and kept on.
That's impossible. Let me just show you a Mobius strip. Let me show you a Mobius strip real quick. There you go. There's a Mobius strip right here. This one's a good one. I like it because it's got DNA and it's a Mobius strip and a serpent. Here's a Mobius strip right here. Here's a Mobius strip. That's funny. I keep seeing Mobius strips that are serpents. Isn't that fascinating? The Mobius strip is a very common symbol used in occult knowledge. Even M.C. Escher, here's an example of a Mobius strip. But M.C. Escher used to do a lot of Mobius strips. But it's very common to see the Mobius strip portrayed as different symbols from ancient iconography from the Egyptians. And let me show you the oldest known Ouroboros ever found is this Egyptian one right here. Isn't that fascinating? A Mobius strip is associated with ancient Egypt. And it's also the Ouroboros. Let me show you something really fascinating. Here is the Mobius strip Ouroboros with an X in the middle with an I. And what's coming out is the single-headed phoenix with this upside-down pyramid. Do you know why? Because this system was the double-headed phoenix. But the two have become one. And it's coming up out of the pit. That's what it means. I understand their language now. That's why they have an X in the middle with the I coming out of the center of the X as a single-headed phoenix. Because the all-seeing eye from the pit is coming up. It's no longer a double-headed phoenix. The two have become one. The new race is here. That's their iconography that they've had for thousands of years. This has been the long-term plan from the beginning. So they can get out. And they want to try and take over heaven. I will rise above the stars of El, the Almighty God. Yep, they're trying to take over. Exactly what they're doing. So anyway, isn't that fascinating? Hang on one sec. Okay, so listen to this. Here's what a Mobius strip is, just by definition.
You know what a Mobius strip is. According to Google, a Mobius strip is a surface with one continuous side formed by joining the ends of a rectangular strip after twisting one end through 180 degrees. Now, 180 degrees is to turn a 2D object upside down. Kind of.
Okay, now think about this. This guy has no idea about my ministry. 100% no line, 100% nylon. But it's exactly correct. Do you understand what you're looking at? In the Avengers,
like the picture, upside down.
The upside, the certificate is upside down. They're making a V over one head, a V over the other head. Look at Tony pointing at him. Well, Spider-Man, he's a hybrid. He's Peter Parker, but he got bit. So inside each human is a spider hunting another one. Think about it. Now we understand all this stuff. That's why in the Avengers, you have this picture. It has Peter Stark pointing at him. And he's Spider-Man. He's got a V over his head, V over his head, and the diploma's upside down. And what's he trying to do? He's trying to achieve time travel. And who's the computer helper that helps Tony Stark? You know who it is? Friday, watch. Let's see.
A model of a time machine using the shape of a Mobius. Friday to try a model of it to his workstation and asks Friday to try a.
So he asks Friday to try a model of a Mobius strip. Did you know the meaning of Friday? Let me show you the meaning of Friday. The name Friday comes from Old English frigidag, meaning the day of fridge, as a result of an old convention associating the Germanic goddess Frigg with the Roman goddess Venus. So Tony is talking to Venus Friday, who he named his computer after, who does help him with all his work, trying to create a time travel through a Mobius strip with an inverted rectangle that stretched and inverted and turned upside down. Oh, that's what Satan's doing. He's trying to get a way out of this dimension before judgment comes. And it's just made manifest right in front of us in movies. What do you think the Ouroboros is all about? And so he's using the human host body system to try and create a way to get out of the pit, which he's going to do. We know that because the Bible says he gets out of the pit. Bunch of locusts come out of the pit. What's been feeding off all the host bodies and all the energy's been going down in the pit to get this race of locusts out. They're coming. And there's a church building out there that's Adam to Locust, and a bell's been rung, and there's red painted on the post and over the lintel. And it just happens to mean he is risen. My Lord is risen. It's like... You hear what I'm saying, folks? Are you guys catching this? So, yeah, even in the Avengers movie, they show you exactly what's going on. That's no different than my truck. That right there. How's that any different than my truck? You got a V and a V, and it's this, you know, this whole system that we're in. But their two that have become one is a double-headed phoenix that's become a single-headed phoenix coming up out of the pit. Now we know everything, and it's coming. So anyway, okay, so y'all should watch this. I don't want to play the whole thing because I don't want a codex violation. So this link is in your show notes. Let me see. Let me get album 5. It's in your show notes. But then let me show you a little video that we also have in our show notes. Watch this. I'll do this. I'll hit tab. We'll go to the top and I'll show you, because I told you it's the female energy that's taken over, right? So you can watch the Avengers thing right here, but watch this. Motherland, Fort Salem, hated and feared, freeform. Here, let's watch this.
It's been in our family for generations, passed from mother to daughter. People have always hated and feared us. So many sick ways to kill us and maim us. Does something like that ever really go away?
I'm going to pause it. So it's a bunch of females standing in the shape of a triangle, you know, like on the truck or V for Vengeance or.
Door that knocketh shall be opened.
Whoever shall knock it shall be opened. So they're saying they're God. Okay, so it's all females, all the witches, standing in the shape of a V.
There's only one battle.
Okay, watch. Pay attention to what they're saying. There's only one battle. I see the upside down thing. There's only one battle. Okay, us against them, and there's half a face. It's always the same.
The one between us and them.
The one between us and them. And what is us? Look at her. They're there like hell burning. Okay, us and them. And then look, the teardrop coming out of the eye. Oh, just like all the sheep I show you. They have the teardrop coming out. Us, the fire that's going to burn them. And them, the sheep. Told you.
It is just the beginning. Dark days await us.
And then all you have to do is look at this. And you see how they split the T right in half and it's forward and backwards. So the same stuff I show you in the Bible is just made manifest in everything they do. Forward and everlasting chains of darkness. And the way they write the letters. Go look at the, like, there's clothing stores called Divided. Just go look it up, Divided. You know what? I'll show it to you. See, I mean, this stuff's everywhere. I mean, it's from the clothing brand store. It's called H&M. But look, divided, and their clothing is a house divided will not stand. And, you know, and then they just, it's just a pure mockery. See, this is no different than a house divided. It's got a line through it. So anyway, you know, this stuff's pervasive. It's everywhere. It's just, are you awake to see it? You know, it's no different than a human in a slave collar becomes a locust from the pit. That's the whole story. I mean, that one picture is the story of the whole earth right here. This one picture. That's from the Vatican. That's a locust from the pit. And it's a human in a slave collar. That's the whole story. And then you can just go through this folder and it's the whole story over and over and over again. Performance art by Marina Abramovic. A guy having sex and a scorpion stinging him in the back. I mean, you know, everything. The lettering on these shoes, H-U. I mean, you know, look, addicted to your poison. Look, addicted to your poison. It's a scorpion. And it's a girl, you know, eating a scorpion. A lost cause. And the words are divided. You see what I mean? Jesus said, any kingdom divided against itself. Look at this. A lost cause. V and V, teardrop coming out of one eye, just like the witch commercial I just showed you. Look, a lost cause, yin and yang on a skull. A lost cause, 666, a serpent and it's a scorpion stinger. I mean, you know, come on, guys. This is so obvious now. What is lurking class? Lurking class. Look, there's a bunch of Black Panthers with bodies laying there dead. Human bodies. I mean, you know, all this stuff that I've accumulated for you guys, the clothing line, 400, it's hunted for dinner. I mean, look at this. Seven up. Seven means to destroy. Up. There's a stinger going through the, that represents the female egg and the stinger with the poison going through it. I mean, you know, look. Look at all this. Look at everything I've done for this. Look at all this. A scorpion, checkerboard pattern, broken promises, broken promises. I mean, you know, all you got to do is go through what I'm showing you. Just go through these folders and look at the accumulation of all this data and all this perfection and information. Just look at it. And by the way, my coat of arms is a crown. And a trumpet. The Lord told me to look it up. Okay. Anyway, I just wanted to kind of throw all that out there. Why did the Lord tell Jonathan Kleck to wear all red and ring the bell on his birthday? Well, I was fulfilling my destiny as Yahweh's given a bell ringer, ding, 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 ding. And Yahweh's given a town crier, ding, 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 hear ye, I go around and I just speak the truth that the Lord God shows me, and I'm acting on behalf of the king. It's that simple. And now it's been made that obvious. And then he's made sure that, you know, I've warned everybody. I did my job. I was supposed to warn you. The end of the world is here. Have you ever seen the whole world shut down before? Okay, well, now you have. The whole world's shutting down. You know why? When you get rid of one system and you're going to bring in a new system, you got to shut down the old system to bring in the new system. The new world order. It's here. They got a perfect cover story for hauling everybody off. They have a perfect cover story. Oh, you got the coronavirus. Oh, you're going to have to take a chip. Oh, yeah, you want your money? Don't worry. We'll give you a chip and you can get back to your bank account. Business as usual. Back to your old life. How bad do you want to be part of their kingdom? You want to be part of the flesh kingdom? Then take the chip. And if you want to go to the spiritual kingdom that I'm from, then don't take the chip if you're here. If you're not here, praise God, you got right. You got to leave with the bride of Christ. And you were counted worthy to get to escape all the horrors that are coming. I bet a lot more people are believing me now, huh? V for victory. The time has come, guys. It's coming. You know it's coming. I know it's coming. Group hug. I love you guys. Yeah, really a Mobius strip right over the center of an X. They're trying to find a way out of here. They're trying to cheat time. They're trying to create a way out. That's what they're trying to do. They're trying to get out of their judgment. That's what's going on. All right, guys. God bless you. Peace and grace. Peace and grace. And keep Tim Sweeney in your prayers. All right, guys. Love you in Christ. God bless. Good night.